I don't pick them up at the thrift store. When I see them, I'm like, ugh, get this away from me. I'm about to be rolling in a dough off of people's inventory, and somebody is gonna fall for it, and my dumb ass did. Welcome back to my channel, Viaglo. If you are new here, my name is Gloria and I'm a full-time reseller on multiple different apps, and I resell clothes and shit. That's exactly what I do. So today I'm going to be talking about the app called Flyp. Now, I'm specifically going to be talking about the pro seller side. If you watch my vlogs, you know that I am a client as well as a pro seller on Flyp. However, today's video is going to be dedicated to the pro seller side of it. So first, I've been on the app for over a month now, like literally like 32 days. So I'm still pretty fresh. I really wanted to wait until I experienced the whole 90 days to do it, but I just thought that for the people that are thinking about getting into the app, I wanted to talk to you right before you get into it, just so you know what's going on before you just make that leap, okay? So first, it's super easy to apply. So when you download the app, all you have to do is apply to it first. I have to get on my desktop in order to apply. That way I can just go to my reselling sites and copy the link, paste it, and call it a day. So then after you do that, they'll notify you whether or not you've been approved the following day. It literally took less than 24 hours for me to be approved. Woke up the next morning at 8 a.m. It said that I was approved and I was excited. Next thing I know, 5 p.m. gets here and I notice that it says items have been dropped or new lots have been dropped. So then that is a prompt for you to go on the app and for you to apply. Now, I feel like with this app, everything is an application, but that's just their style. So you'll go on the app and usually it's between 90 to like 120 lots that have dropped. These are literally just lots of clothing that people have taken photos of and they want you to sell it for them. So you go on there, you're able to scroll through as many as you want. Make sure you put the commission that you want in it. So let's say you apply for a lot and what ends up happening, the application, it basically is you giving a about me section in this, and then you'll also be given your commission rate. So you can do 45, 50, 35, 40, like you pretty much get the gist. But a lot of pro sellers, they do the 60-40. So I haven't had much luck with trying to do the 60-40, so I've been working at the 40-60 as of late, just to, I guess, try to get my feet wet. And then once I sell a lot more items on Flyp, then I can start bumping up my commission rate. Because so with Flyp, it likes to showcase the item that you've sold. They usually put the highest item sold first, so then people can go to your page and reference like, oh, okay, they sold this item for X amount of dollars. So then they can have like a mindset of like, okay, so this person sells items around this price, so I'm willing to take the chance on them. So anyway, so once you give your commission and then you put your about me section, you apply, and then you wait until the next morning. So usually that following morning at 8 a.m. they'll notify you that you've been matched. Once you've been matched, the person accepts your commission, then that's when you send them an estimate of what you can sell their items for. Once you do that, you'll send it in to them, and what ends up happening, the client will look it over and they'll be like, oh, okay, that's not bad. And then they'll accept it. So then at that point, the client will ship all of their items to you. Once you receive the items, the timer starts at that very moment. So you have 90 days to sell their items. Now, I have not made it to the 90-day mark with their items, so I'll most likely be doing a follow-up video just to let you guys know a little bit more of what has happened. But you have 90 days to sell their items, and we'll talk about what happens if it's not sold within those 90 days in the future. So just look out for that video in 2 more months. All right, so now that you've made it to the process where the items have came to you and you are prepping for them, you have already taken the photos, you've already got them pushed out to all of your reselling platforms, and item sales. Great, love that for you. So the item sales, we'll talk about this Lily Pulitzer dress because it's hitting home while I talk about it, okay? So you sell an item, let's say it sells for $50. Your commission is $40.60. So that means that the client will get $30 and you'll get the $20. Not bad, right? Love that for you. You'll go back into the Flyp app and then you'll mark the item as sold. And then you'll put in the amount that it sold for on that site. Now, how I have mine set up, I like to underprice my items when I send in my estimate. So for my Lily Pulitzer dresses, I said that I would sell them between $20 to $40. this particular dress sold for $50. So of course, even better, right? So they get their $30. So then that leaves you with $20. But you have to be smart about it. You don't want to just be like, oh great, I just made $20 on this item. You can't do that, because you will be pleasantly upset when you find out how much you actually got. So what ends up happening on Flyp is that you incur all the fees that that specific selling app has. So if you are on Poshmark, you know that they take 20%. If you're on Depop or Mercari, they take 13 to 14%. I'm not really sure about eBay's percentage. I still don't know what eBay's percentage is. Like, make it make sense. Like, they are not really forthcoming with that. But if you do know eBay's percentage, please let me know down below in the comments, because I still don't know what it is, and I've been selling on eBay for like 3 or 4 months now. Still don't know how much they take from me, which is terrible. So you'll deduct how much you made on the Flyp app, so that $20, and then you'll go to the app and you'll see how much they took. You will be highly disappointed, like how I was. So yeah, I said all of that to let you know that you are gonna be incurring all of the fees which the item sells on. So just be mindful of that, because you just don't want to have your hopes kind of high and then you be disappointed when you see like, wow, this is it. This is all I got from this. So there's that. So since we're pretty much at the end of this, I want to talk about the pros and cons. So the only pro of being a pro seller is you are getting free inventory. That's literally it. Like, I don't see anything else about this app being good but getting free inventory. The con is you are getting trash inventory with a few good pieces sprinkled in. Now, I'm not trying to come for the Flyp clients by, you know, saying that their items are trash, but you know as a seller what you like to sell, because when you go thrifting, you pick up the same items, you pick up Bolo brands, you pick up Bolo styles, so you have an idea of what is gonna sell. When you are going on the Flyp app, you don't. You are getting their trash, in essence. The good thing about it is that you can see what they're selling. So the other night I was on the app, I was applying for lots, and I noticed that one particular person had nothing but tall bits. I don't sell tall bits at all. I don't pick them up at the thrift store. When I see them, I'm like, ugh, get this away from me. But I know that it's people that sell tall bits items, so they would apply for that lot. So that's pretty much like the mindset of it. And no person is gonna have a lot where they have all of the items that you love to sell. Granted, it could be people like me as a client. If y'all watch my vlogs, I literally curated each lot that I placed on Flyp, which made it easier for the pro seller to pick which one they wanted, because I had an Athleta lot, I had a Victoria's Secret lot, I had a Torrid lot, I had a Soft Surroundings lot, and so on and so forth. So not everybody does that. Everybody, they'll have like good pieces mixed in with bad pieces. So prime example, one of my lots, I have somebody that put Patagonia, Soft Surrounding. They also put a whole bunch of garbage. I'm not gonna name those brands, but a whole bunch of garbage brands that I have to figure out, like, what the hell. It was Chico's. Like, I don't sell Chico's, but I knew that I wanted to sell that Patagonia sweater, and I knew I was gonna get a lot for it, so that's why I applied for the lot. And I'm not sure if clients do that on purpose. Honestly, I could see them doing that on purpose. Like, I actually can when I think about it, because you know that somebody is gonna wanna sell these items, so let me place all of these shitty items that I don't wanna sell with this lot, and somebody is gonna fall for it, and my dumb ass did. But I digress. So I did not know that you can actually exclude items from lots. Now that I know that, I actually just found this out yesterday. I was watching somebody's YouTube video and they talked about it, and she's been selling since August. So there's that. So I wanted to just, you know, throw that in there to let y'all know that you can exclude items. I'm actually gonna test it out tonight when I apply for some lots, just to see. Hopefully I can apply, because that's another thing I completely forgot to add in this. As a con, you are rewarded with being able to get more lots when you sell more lots, which it makes sense. It's just annoying, because if you just want to only sell the Flyp lots, you can't. You have to keep selling in order to unlock another amount. Sell more, unlock another amount, and then it just keeps going. So there's that. You have to pay the full app fee. Now, I personally think that it should be split down the middle. I 100%. I think that the fee of selling on the platform and then also the $5 service fee that Flyp has started should be split down the middle. I think it should be a 50-50 automatically. I don't think people should pick their commissions, but I'm sure Flyp doesn't care about my little opinion. But I think that it would have been more beneficial if they had it to where. So I was basically trying to say that I think that the fee from Flyp and then the fee from the platform and then how much the item sold for should actually be split down the middle. So then that way the client and the pro seller takes a 50-50 cut. So both of them will incur the Flyp fee and then also the platform fee. And I think that that would be best. Like, another thing that I do not like about the app is that some clients are not forthcoming with the damages that are on the items. I know one of my clients, she clearly is a reseller, or she is trying to liquidate all of her items. So she is just putting anything into boxes. It was an item that I was missing, and then it was also an added extra item in one of those lots. And it's just kind of like, what are you doing, sis? And then also some of the items were damaged and they weren't disclosed in like the little bit of the listing. And since I was new to the Flyp app and she was my first person that I like won the lot for, I didn't know that I could say like, hey, this item is like damaged. So when I got the item in and I checked and seen everything was here, I said that the lot is good and I like signed off on it. And when it's time for me to list the items, I noticed that it's the damages that were undisclosed. So that really does hurt when it's time to sell the item, because now I have to mark it down even more because you didn't tell me that this was damaged. That's something that I don't like. And then I also don't think that they should allow damaged items to be put on the site. Like, I don't think that should be an option. Like, very minor, if it's like a very tiny stain or something of that nature, maybe. But if you are really just sending in items that has rips and holes in it, that shouldn't be allowed. Like, the same way that the Flyp app like vets you if you want to apply, they should vet the items that are also being listed. So if they see like holes, they can be like, you know what, this actually doesn't work. Like, we don't want to sell this on here. Our resellers can't sell this item because it's badly damaged. But that is it. That's all I have to say about being a pro seller on the app. But I do want to give it a rating, because as y'all may know already, I like to rate things. Like, if y'all watch my Depop video, if y'all watch my Poshmark video, I like to rate things because I want you guys to know. And I'm gonna be completely honest with you. As a pro seller on Flyp, I rate it a 4 out of 10. I know, pretty bad, right? Especially because I'm gonna continue to use the app. But we'll be talking about that more in my vlog. So if you guys don't watch my vlogs, make sure you watch my vlogs, because I'm gonna be giving y'all more behind the scenes of my thought process, behind the scenes of my videos, just behind the scenes of my life. But that is it. Thank y'all so much for tuning in and watching this video. Please make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know down below if you've thought about using the app. Let me know if you use the app. Let me know if you've decided that it's probably not in your best interest to use it because your girl is trying to look out for you. But I think you should also test it out for yourself just to see, you know. It's okay to get your feet wet. It's totally okay. But I just wanted to do this video to let you know that you should definitely go in with a open mind instead of a, ooh, I'm about to be rolling in a dough off of people's inventory. Like, that's just not the case at all. Oh, also, so I'm gonna be doing a separate video on me being a client on the Flyp app. So I'll talk to you guys later. Thank you guys so much for tuning in and watching this video. Please have a good rest of your day.